Welcome to the 8th All-Star Family Feud Special, introducing for the first game the Dallas family. Steve Keneally, Charlene Tilton, Mary Crosby, Randy Powell, and Ken Kershaw. Ready for action. Playing against the Benson family. Robert Guillaume, Missy Gold, Louis J. Sadlin, Inga Swenson, and James Noble. On your mark, let's start the All-Star Family Feud Special. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
This is, of course, ABC, and ABC is the daring network. They try and get something different to put on the air. They've got a show that's been on the air just a few weeks. It's in the top 10. I'm not knocking the show. It was a show, they couldn't think of a title of it, because it was such a weird show. People breaking bricks over their heads, and people who read with their ears. It's true. They finally got the title when the producer heard that ABC bought it. He said, "That's incredible." We got four great, great people. They've all come, four great shows have come on to play for charity. You know, they're beautiful. They give up their days off to do this. So, well, let's get the show on the road. Welcome my buddies, Dallas. Come on, let's go. How are you?
You
got promoted. It's good to see you. You were winners the last time here, weren't you?
Well, we like the competition, but there's nothing like winning. It's really good for the soul, you know what I mean?
What did you win the last time? 15,000?
15 big ones. That's right.
Yeah, boy, oh boy. What charity will you play for?
We're playing for the Kennedy Child Study Center in Santa Monica.
Man, let me meet them all again.
This is Charlene Tilton that plays little lovely Lucy on our show. And next to her is Mary Crosby, the rather devious Kristen. And one of her partners in crime is Randy Powell, that plays Alan Beam, and our arch enemy, Ken Kershaw, Cliff Barnes.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
All right, now I'm just going to say hi to him before we get over there.
They're all real tough competitors.
I met this little doll.
How
are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
And you were on the last time. You reminded me that you were a little girl when I met you. I was doing Hogan's Heroes, right?
Yes.
I gave you some chewing gum.
Yes, you did.
You should have been arrested.
Yes, he did.
I was hoping now that she's grown up, you'd remember that. Fondly.
I still have the picture.
Hi, how are you?
Good to meet you. Fine,
nice to see you. You're not worried about anything, are you?
No.
Going to have a good time?
Yes. Now,
Randy, we're well delighted to have you here. Everything, you ever done a show like this before? Any other game?
Only Pyramid, or? Well, only in Mason City, Iowa. I don't know if it really counts.
What's the big game there?
Hog calling.
Ready to play this?
I'm very ready to play
this. This is a good team here. They've been here as well. They're my buddies, the Bensons. Let's welcome them.
How you doing?
Oh, nice to see you. What's your charity, Robert?
Well, we're going to try sickle cell anemia.
That's a charity you're playing for. Well done. Okay. Can I meet them all, please?
Yes. This lady here is our resident genius. This is Missy Gold.
Hi, darling.
Hi.
This is Louis J. Stadlin. He's the governor's aide. This is Inga Swenson. She plays Krause.
Why are you breaking up?
Because I don't remember what these people do.
Oh, I see.
On the end is Jim Noble, is the governor.
Good to see you, governor. All right.
What is that? Is that mistletoe?
You're so gorgeous. I want to give you my flower.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're marvelous. There's a pin that goes with it. Maybe Robert will pin that on for you a little later. How old are you?
I'm 9 and a half.
Are you?
Yeah.
How long have you been acting?
For 3 years.
Really? You're an old timer then. Yeah?
Yeah.
Is this the biggest, not this, but Benson, is that the biggest part you ever had?
Yeah.
Well, anybody on the show you don't like?
No, I love everybody.
She's an actress. Perfect actress.
Oh, she's lovely.
Kids like that steal scenes just by being there. That's why you'll never notice any little kids helping me out. Hello, darling.
Hello, Richard.
You're not nervous. I can see a big twinkle and a smile.
No, not very. Just a little.
And here is the governor. If you were going to cast the governor, right, this is the perfect man to play it. Governor James.
Yeah. Delighted to have you. Come on, let's play the few. Let's go, Rob.
You, Steve?
Hey, I can wish you all the luck here. You're going to need it.
Okay, you're going to need it too.
There's $5,000 here at stake, and 200 points, of course, will win the game. 100 people surveyed, top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
Yes. Secretary.
Secretary. Very good. One answer will beat it, Steve. An occupation which women have to put up men making passes at them.
Stewardess in an airline.
A stewardess. You got control. You want to play or pass?
You want to play or pass?
Play.
Okay, we're going to play.
Okay, team.
I thought stewardess would have been a little higher than that. Said we want you to name a job which women have to put up with men making passes at them. You know what that is when a man makes a pass at you, don't you? Yeah? Like I did with you with the flower. I try to get on your good side.
A waitress.
A waitress. Waitress, please. The number one answer. One answer. 9.5? If I find out you're a midget and you've been lying on me. An occupation which women have to put up with men making passes at them, huh?
An actress.
Aha! An actress? Eight people said it. And my name comes to roll along. Just one answer left, madame. You have a nice big lead.
How about a band singer?
Band singer? First strike. 3 of those, they get a chance to steal. Come along, Governor. An occupation which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
Dental assistant.
Don't look at me like that, Angus.
You're making bets.
In all, it may be there, but in all fairness, you know, when you're frozen up in that chair and you have that one bit of dribble going to you in that spittoon. It's the last time I would make a pass at you, but it might be there. Let's take a look. A dental assistant? Not there. Robert, 2 strikes, but only 1 answer left, sir. An occupation which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
Well, the only thing I can think of is nurse.
Mm. There's a goodie.
A beauty, Robert. A beauty.
The old I've taken a turn for the nurse gag. If it's there, you got it all. If not, Dallas, get ready to steal. Nurse! Not thou. What do you think, Steve?
Stripper! Stripper!
Oops. Well, Charlene. Well, we sure thought it was nurses, I want to tell you.
Yeah, I must say I did.
Model?
We think dancer.
A dancer?
Yeah. Stripper.
Stripper
dancer.
Exotic dancer.
An exotic dancer. Well, I have to take it from him.
Just say dancer, please.
All right. Just dancer?
Because that covers a lot of ground, right?
Okay, fine. Dancer's up there, $74 for you. If not, give it to the Bensons. A dancer? You got it. Number 4. Model. They had it, and they threw it away. There's $74 there, nothing there. Come on, little dog.
Good luck to you, sweetheart.
Good luck to you.
This isn't fair. Putting those blue eyes against it's not fair.
You okay?
Yeah.
You can reach that all right? Good girl. Yeah, I just want to make sure.
So can I.
All right, so if you're ready, here we go, okay? 100 people surveyed. The top 8 answers are on the board. Here is the question. Name a game that only kids play. Yeah.
Jump rope.
Jump rope. Not there. Really?
Hopscotch.
Hopscotch. Number one. You gonna play or you gonna pass?
We're gonna play.
They're gonna play, darling. You go back there. All righty.
Think like a little person.
Game that only kids play.
Dolls.
Playing dolls. First strike. Randy, what do you think kids play?
Jacks.
Jacks. You got it. $35 there. Ken?
Tag.
Yeah. Sounds like you're bidding. Huh? Any of our 100 people say tag.
Yeah.
Very good. $51. Five answers left. Steve?
I know some adults that play this game. It's sort of like tag. It's hide and seek.
Okay.
But, you know,
hide and seek.
Hey.
I do know some adults. Well, a little love.
Oh, I've got two in mind. Play house.
Yeah. Same one I had in mind.
Adults play that too.
When I gave that chewing gum tour about 10 years ago, exactly the same game. Isn't it strange? We were both. House!
Okay.
Three answers left. Yes, dear.
On the theme of house, doctor.
Doctor.
House.
Oh, please.
A little game of doctor. Suddenly turning into a rather risque question. I thought it was quite innocent. Game, old kids play.
Cowboys and Indians.
Ah! Oh, yeah, of course. Oh. Right.
Cowboys and Indians. A game that only kids play.
Cops and robbers.
Hey, that's
no
it.
More. Cops and robbers, you've got it all. Cops and robbers. Great answer, just didn't make it. One answer left and two strikes on you. See? Game that only kids play.
Oh, boy. Dodgeball.
Dodgeball. I gather that's where you're trying to.
It's a playground game. The kids throw the ball. It's dodgeball.
Ball being thrown at you.
Gosh.
Dodgeball's there. Clean sweep. You got it all. If not, Benson's get ready to steal. Dodgeball! Not there. Chance here now. Come along, Robert. Children?
Yes?
Chance for you to get a big lead in this game. $76 up there. One answer left.
What is it?
Pin the tail on the donkey.
Your technical advisor gave it to you there? Okay. Pin the tail on the donkeys there. You get the $76, a big lead in the game. If not, it's going to be very even because you get the money. Pin the tail on the donkey. You got it. Number four. Green. Yeah, that's with Rosie Greer, I think, isn't it? 76 there, 74 there. Let's go.
I know, my hand is right here.
All right, okay.
Dollar values are doubled. Remember, 200 now makes wins the game. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here is the question. Name something that feels rough to the touch. Yes.
A rug?
No. Rough.
Did you get the question?
Something that feels rough to the touch.
Sandpaper?
Racial or pass. Talk it over.
Let's play.
Probably heard that. Something that feels rough to the touch.
Oh, it's me?
Mm-hmm. You're not rough at all.
No, I know. I'm a nice lady. How about a file?
Okay. May we see a file? Not there. First try. James, what do you think? Feels rough to the touch.
Wool.
Pardon?
Wool.
That's why you never see anyone ever pet a lamb. Wool? No. Robert, I hope you've got a goodie there because you got two strikes on you. Something that feels rough to the touch.
Beard.
A
Beard, okay. Beard's there, you're all right. If not, third strike. Beard!
I'm the Zane.
What do you think?
Rocks.
Rocks?
Yeah.
Okay. They are. They're kind of rough, aren't they?
Yeah.
Let's take a look and see if it's there, if it made our survey. Rocks up there, you're all right. If not, third strike from the Dallas. Then we'll have enough money to steal and be the champs. Rocks! Not there. Here you go, champs. What do you say? We notice the speed.
What a toughie.
Kind of stuff.
But I think we have finally settled for the bark of a tree.
Oh, okay.
No?
No.
Well, I thought.
Was that your answer?
We don't know.
Mustache.
What do you say? Bark of a tree? I mean, is that the answer?
What
I have
is
to
it,
take.
You guys?
See, Beard, we liked Beard.
Callus.
That's very
callus.
Nice.
Callus.
So
gonna...
callus.
They're
gonna... Hey, wait, this.
Yeah, they're going to buzz you.
Callus.
Give me an
it's a callus.
Callus.
All right, a callus.
A callus.
Callus for Dallas. If it's there, you get the 170. You'll have the money. You will be in the finals, and you'll play for $5,000. If not, Robert Jurgelman. A callus! Number three. A brush. Number four. All righty, now you played for the Kennedy Child Center. You have $76. They were going to wipe that out. We're going to make it $1,000.
Hey,
okay?
Thank you very much.
Stay in Route Vermont. I need two people to play. Who's going to do it? Come on, two people. Two people, please. Who's first? Who's first?
Who wants to be first?
All right. England and Robert are going for the money right after we watch this. Well done.
You're watching Feud Friday, only on Game Show Network. Stay tuned.
Yeah, your favorite show on the Game Show Network with the president chick, Nixon.
It's Kennedy, you dumb foe.
Yeah. Well, they got all new episodes with new friends and new foes and the whole friending deal.
Be a good fella and watch all new episodes of Friend or Foe tonight at 10:30 on Game Show Network.
GEICO's always been about savings, but he really brought customer service to a whole new level.
We settle a ton of claims in under 48 hours.
Guaranteed claim repairs? That was his idea.
Customer satisfaction is at an all-time high.
You know what he represents? A commitment to excellence.
And he deserves this award.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
What's more hateful than a tangerine taffeta bridesmaid dress? Having to wear one with your period. Don't stress. Kotex has a different kind of ultra-thin with quick-absorbing pores and wings that readjust with strips by Velcro USA for a secure fit. It's great protection. So even if you don't catch the bouquet, no reason you won't catch the eye of that cute DJ. Kotex fits. Period.
Are you in on it? Go to CheapTickets.com for tons of unpublished airfares you won't find anywhere else. Or call now for our lowest prices on airfares, hotels, rental cars, and last-minute trips. Want to save even more? Check out our last-minute trip specials now and save up to 60%. Cheap Tickets, the best-kept secret in travel.
You okay?
I think so.
Sure you are. Robert's off stage, earphones on, he can't hear us. $5,000 here for Sickle Cell Disease Research Center, okay? Mm-hmm. You can do it. We can just get
okay.
the money. Then you're in the finals for
$10,000. Oh, I hope so.
That's for luck.
Oh, thank you.
You're not rough to the touch at all. 15 seconds, please. If you could choose, at what hour would you get up every morning?
10.
Name an award show.
Oscars.
A fruit that begins with the letter P.
Pear.
A door you knock on before entering.
Bedroom.
A kind of puzzle.
Crossword.
Turn around. Yes, you like it, huh? You could choose at what hour would you get up every morning? You said 10. Survey said 26 points. An award show, you said
Oscar's survey said 55 out of 81. Bruce, at the beginning of the letter P, you said, bless you, you said pear. Survey said 39, you have 120. The door you knocked on before entering, you said bedroom. I always do that at home.
Yes, it's very smart.
Yes, well, no, it's not really smart. I live alone.
Oh!
Consequently, I never get to go in the bedroom because no one ever says, come in. But the day they do, I'm going to have the towel. Oh, I'm sorry, Missy, just a little show business joke. Survey said 9, you have 129. Kind of puzzle. You sort of couldn't think of one for a while, and then you said crossword. And our survey said, look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Standing right next to Mr. Here's Roberto.
What'd you do?
Woo! I'm going to ask the same questions I asked Amy. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear that? I say try again. You give me another answer, champ, okay?
Okay.
Please remind everyone the answers Inga gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock. You know we wish you luck.
Okay.
Here we go. You're 20 points away from the money. If you could choose, at what hour would you get up every morning?
7.
Name an award show.
Academy.
Try again.
Music awards.
A fruit that begins with the letter P.
Pineapple.
A door you knock on before entering.
Lavatory.
A kind of puzzle.
Jigsaw.
Turn around. If you could choose, at what hour would you get up every morning?
7.
No, because when you do a series, 7 o'clock, you're really laying in. You said 7, I believe. Okay, I'll give you a call tomorrow. Oh, good. You're 20 points away, and our survey said 6. 9 a.m. 9 a.m. was the number one answer. You now need 14 points in award show. You said the music awards? Okay. 14 points for $5,000. Survey said 4. The Oscars was the number one answer. Then we wanted a fruit. Begins with the letter P. You said a pineapple. 10 points for $5,000. Survey said 3.
Something's coming. Something you didn't expect. Something you won't believe. Haunted Travels Week on the Travel Channel with your enchanting host, Melissa Joan Hart. From haunted hotels to ghostly castles, she'll show you what's really lurking in the shadows. Scared? She'll hold your hand. Haunted Travels Week begins Monday at 8, only on the Travel Channel, Channel 220.
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
I will feel better about my dad living by himself.
I will know my children are safe.
I will go on vacation and finally be able to relax!
ADT's advanced technology and skilled professionals help more people feel safe in more ways than any other security company. Call now and get ADT's sophisticated burglary system installed for as little as $99. You could also save up to 20% off your basic homeowner's insurance.
I will live my life.
My life.
My life.
On my terms!
Call now and get the ADT burglary system from $99 installed, plus up to 20% off homeowner's insurance. ADT. Always there.
Present some papers to the court.
When an ambitious attorney collides with a desperate father.
It says you're bankrupt.
Sorry, I gotta go.
Oh, man, don't leave me out here like this.
Sorry, better luck next time.
They become trapped in a cycle of violence that neither man can escape.
Can you give me that?
I like.
Can you give me that?
Pay-Per-View presents Academy Award nominee Samuel L. Jackson and Academy Award winner Ben Affleck in a suspense thriller that will leave you breathless. Changing Lanes, now on Pay-Per-View. Rated R for Language.
More terrifying than a double whammy. Scarier than a trap door. More frightening than a lovely parting gift. It's Hollywood Scares, 3 hours of the freakiest game shows ever known to man. Join Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, for a night of spooktacular fun.
Spooktacular?
See Hollywood Scares, Saturday from 9 to midnight only on Game Show Network. Brought to you by M&M's Chocolate Candies. Have them at your Halloween party.
It's time for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special, introducing the WKRP in Cincinnati family. Gordon Jump, Jen Smithers, Frank Bonner, Tim Reed, and Richard Sanders, ready for action. Playing against the Angie family, Robert Hayes, Deborah Lee Scott, Doris Roberts, Sharon Spellman, and Nancy Lane. On your marks for the second game of the All-Star Family Feud Special. And here once again is the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
How are you, man?
Hi, Richard. How are you?
Time you were with us, you won a lot of money?
Yes, we did. We won $15,000.
Yeah, over $15,000, yeah. So we know you're a winner. Who are you going to play for this time?
We're going to play for St. John's Hospital.
Okay, well, congratulations. May I meet you, Sam?
You certainly may. To my left is Jan Smithers, Frank Bonner, Tim Reed, and Richard Sanders.
All is well, Richard?
Everything is very well. I just returned from skiing in Oklahoma, as a matter of fact.
Famous. Very hard to do there, I believe.
Yeah, it's really, really difficult, but I was skiing up on the Lonnie Anderson Peaks. It's a thrilling place.
The grand, yeah. Welcome. Oh, no, I love that. I eat more lipstick during the show. We kept you up. I saw you yell. Everything okay?
Wonderful.
Tim, how are you? Good to see you. What should I know about you that I don't know?
Nothing, because I
don't know. That's good. If a man doesn't waste my time, so definitely I move straight on here to the skier.
Yes.
Looking very dapper, Richard, if I may say so.
Thank you. I've noticed you never kiss the men, is
I
there?
I will.
Thank you.
Thank you, friend. My buddy's from Angie, old Challenger, right here. What charity are you collecting?
This time we decided to do something for some people that did a lot for a lot of people. The past rains that we had, they were helping save people's lives and their belongings and everything. The tree people up in at the top.
Yeah. Well, they're dynamite too.
Yeah, they're doing other things too. Solar energy and
good people. Good cause. We just feel like them. You know I know them, but let's meet them all.
Sure. My sister-in-law, Deborah Lee Scott.
Hello.
Hello.
My mother-in-law, Doris Roberts.
It's still my heart.
Oh, yes.
My sister, Sharon Spellman.
Hi.
And one of our infamous three Marys, Nancy Lane.
Good to see you. Little darling. Nancy's first time.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Okay. All right, now we got $5,000 at stake here, and the winner out of the two of you, of course, will be in the finals to play for all the money. Are you ready to do this? Let's play the feud. Come on!
All right.
100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Try and find the most popular answer if you can. Here is the question. Name something associated with Dean Martin.
Jerry Lewis.
Jerry Lewis.
Jerry Lewis. One answer, Gordon, will beat that.
Singing.
Singing. Oh, boy, you got too close.
You played.
Yeah. We're going to play it, Gordon. We're going to play it. I'd have thought Jerry Lewis would have been number one.
Yeah. Yeah.
I get my kiss.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
Something associated with Dean Martin.
Drinking.
Yes.
Everybody loves you. How long have I been on? Drinking. That's number one.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think? Associated with Dina.
Gold Diggers?
Ah. Yeah. It's a group that worked with them. The Gold Diggers. Not bad. First strike, three of those, they get a chance to steal.
Hello, Richard.
Hello. What do you think? something associated with Dean Martin.
A television show. Okay. Yeah.
He was on TV, show? Right? TV! Not there. I know this is your first time.
It's always hard. It's the hard. First time. Yes, I. How about movies?
Movies, okay. Yeah. Movies up there, you're all right. If not, third strike. Group over there get a chance to steal. Movies! Not there. WKRP, there's $88 waiting to be stolen. If you can give me a correct answer, come on back. Good. This would be a good time to come forward with that correct answer, of course.
The roast.
Oh, that's very good, the roast, yeah. The Dean Martin roast.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's probably what they call it, the Dean Martin roast. Roast's up there, $88 for you. If not, give it to Robert and his family. The roast! Number three, please. We'll be back right after this.
You're watching Feud Friday, only on Game Show Network. Stay tuned.
It is the great unknown. Some say your life flashes before your eyes. Some say there's a white light at the end of a long tunnel. Soon, they're gonna find out.
Russian Roulette, tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
It's a beautiful morning.
Ask your doctor about Vioxx, a prescription medicine from Merck. And find out if Vioxx is right for you. Vioxx.
Dave Logan is single. He goes on many dates.
What is it that you do?
I'm a lawyer.
I hate lawyers.
And he uses his Discover card.
Check, please.
So far, he's built up a cashback bonus award of over $160.
You're kind of boring.
Check, please.
What do you think this thing's going between us? Because, you know, my clock's kind of ticking.
Check, please.
It's money he'll use for an engagement ring someday.
So, what do you do for a living?
Maybe someday soon.
I'm a lawyer.
Discover Card's new cashback bonus program.
Really?
Where you get paid for the things you buy anyway.
During the Suzuki year-end clearance, you'll get the best prices of the year. Start with zero down, 0% financing for 5 years, and now for a limited time, you'll also get $1,000 customer cash for the best price all year on the hot new Aereo, the XL7 SUV, and every O2 model. Every Suzuki also comes with America's best warranty for 100,000 miles, making Suzuki America's best value. Take a test drive now before the Suzuki year-end clearance is over. Hurry in.
$88 there. Thank nothing you. There. Come along, Deborah Lee. Jan, my baby. Want to wish each other luck?
Hmm?
Want to wish each other luck?
Oh, yes. Good luck.
All right.
Put it down.
It's my job. I'll tell. 100 people surveyed. Top 7 answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something you might do very badly the first time you try it.
Yes. Make love.
Make love. Five answers will beat it, Jan. Something you might do very badly the first time you try it.
Roller skate.
Roller skate. Gonna play or pass? Talk it over with your family.
We're gonna pass.
You're gonna pass it. Okay.
Oh.
All right.
Okay.
I was kind of glad to see only 4 people said make love. Only 4 people's had a bad time. James, something.
Dance.
Okay. Dara said dance. Not that.
Oh.
First strike.
Okay. I say cook.
Oh, that could be good. Well, we're looking for cook. You got it.
Drive a car.
Oh, good one.
Thanks.
Drive a car. Very good. $41 there. 3 answers left. 1 strike. Robert?
Well, I don't know how many sports-minded people would be out there. Snow skiing.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, well, I did terribly the first time.
Skate! $5, 2 answers left.
Ride a bicycle.
Oh, oh yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Very good.
But release it, ride a bike. $70. One more answer. If it's correct, you've got it all. Something you might.
So.
Oh, good answer.
Pardon?
So.
Oh, I thought you.
So what's new, you mean?
Exactly. I thought it was the old Jewish. So. So? Just take a look. Wouldn't it be a mitzvah if it was there?
Yeah.
So. Not
that.
Oh, second strike. Oh. Sharon.
Play cards.
Play cards. Not there. $70 there. Nice big lead if you get it. What do you say, Gordon?
What is it, gang?
Singing.
Hey.
Singing.
You like it? Little gas.
Absolutely right, Pat Boone. April love. Singing's there. $70 for you. Big lead. If not, Angie gets the 70. Singing. Win. $88,000. $70 there. Let's go.
Come on.
I'm sorry, we were interrupting something, were we?
Yes, we were. We are.
I'm sorry. Feuding among ourselves.
All righty. Now the dollar values are doubled. First family, get there now. 200. Play for 5,000. Also play Benson for the 10,000. Here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something politicians hand out freely around election time.
Kisses.
Kisses? Oh, wide open for you.
Cigars.
Cigars? Not there. Tim?
Promises.
Yeah. Promises?
All right.
John? One answer will beat it. Something politicians hand out freely around election time.
Pamphlets.
Pamphlets? Pamphlets? Gonna play or pass?
Play.
Let's play. Why not?
We are?
We're gonna play.
What are you gonna do?
Pass.
Okay, sports fans.
One moment, Richard.
I guess
we've never been a show done that way.
Different drummer, I guess, huh? You hear it's a different drummer. All right. Name something politicians hand out freely around election time.
Handshakes.
Yes.
Oh, good.
Are there any handshakes? Not bad. Oh. Robert?
My goodness. And you thought they made a mistake passing. Oh. Hand out freely during elections. Mm-hmm. They've got baloney. I would say, promises.
Jeez.
Two.
Just a game.
Just, that's right, I forgot.
Yeah, this is like I brought him news he's going to have open heart surgery. It's a game, it's all. It's something politicians hand out freely around election time.
Money. I don't know.
Money.
Well, you know, they did campaigns and stuff.
Okay. Money's there, okay. If not, third strike. You get a chance to redeem yourself. Money! Not there. What do you say now? It's smart if you've
smart.
Got the right answer.
We've
what do you think?
Campaign buttons.
Uh-huh. Campaign buttons is a good one. $56 for you if it's there. If not, you get it. Campaign button. Bumper sticker. 144.70. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. This could decide it. 100 people surveyed. No, 100 women. No men. 100 women surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here's the question we asked the women. We said, name something you use that comes in a push-button can.
Deodorant.
Deodorant?
All right!
Yeah. 100 women, we said, name something you use that comes in a push-button can.
Hairspray.
A well-known German, hairspray!
All right.
Doc. Those are the only two I know.
Led a very sheltered life. What do you think? 100 women. We said, name something you use that comes in a push-button can.
Deodorant, hairspray. All I can think of is that Pam spray for the...
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They use that in the kitchen.
Vegetable spray for cooking spray.
Yeah, it's a vegetable spray. See, they're as worried about it as you are. That's right. Beverly?
Pledge, you know, to shine your table.
Oh, yeah.
Furniture polish.
Something you use. It comes in a push-button can. We asked 100 women. There's one answer up there. If you get it, you will play for $5,000. You'll be in the final.
Bug spray.
Good.
Oh,
bug spray. Good.
That's
wonderful.
Oh, let's see. Bug spray. If it's there, you got it. Second strike.
Okay.
Yes.
Up to me again,
yes,
right?
Please. Yeah,
come on. Air freshener. Room air freshener. Yeah!
Now, if that's there, you've got it. If not, you get ready. Air freshener. $170 will make you the champs. What do you say?
Disinfected. The type of thing that you spray to cleanse, cleansers, disinfect.
Spin it right out there.
Gordon has an album coming out with this actual answer. What is it?
Disinfectant spray.
All right, fine, yeah. Disinfectant's there, 170 for you. If not, Angie gets it and they'll play for the money. Disinfectant! Now, Jim, you have $144, which we will wipe away and give you $1,000 for the St. John's Hospital.
Oh,
ask you to stay here and leave. I need two people. Let's go. Come on. Woo! Who's first? Your sister. All righty, here we go. Well, let me know that when Deborah leaves, you're playing for the tree people.
Yes.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
She can't hear us. Let's get a nice big score.
Okay.
That's for luck. The tree people, $5,000. 15 seconds, please. Name the room in your house that gets the most use.
Den.
Something that birds do.
Wash.
A food that comes in a bottle.
Ketchup.
Something delivered to people's homes.
Pizza.
Something you do with your mouth.
Kiss.
Turn around. Name the room in your house that gets the most use. You said the den. You have a lot of bears to dinner, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Survey said 9. Something that birds do. You said wash. That's where the expression comes from. Well, I'll be a dirty bear. Survey said 0. Oh. Food that comes in a bottle, you said. Ketchup. Survey said 25. Something delivered to people's homes, you said a pizza. Survey said 0. Something you do with your mouth, you said kiss. Survey said 12. Clear the board, please. Don't worry, you go back, stand next to Robert. All move downward, Angel. Move downward. Now, here's Beverly. Come on, little girl. You're going to ask the same questions I asked Sam. You can't duplicate her answers. If you do hear that, I say try again. Give me another answer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Please remind everyone the answer Sharon gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock.
Mm-hmm.
Look at me.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're... that was for luck. No. I just didn't want to get involved. Here we go. Name the room in your house that gets the most use.
Bedroom.
Something that birds do.
Fly.
A food that comes in a bottle.
In a bottle. Ketchup.
Try again.
Coca-Cola.
Something delivered to people's homes.
Newspaper.
Something you do with your mouth.
Kiss.
Try again.
Eat.
Turn around.
Show does it to me every time.
You're fine.
Hi. This
room
gets
in your
me
house
crazy.
That gets the most use. You said.
Hi.
Bedroom. And as you said that, nine guys in the audience prepared to follow you home. Survey said, six. Kitchen, number one answer, kitchen. Something birds do, you said, fly. It was the number one answer. Survey said, four. You got 97. Food comes in a bottle, you said, Coke. Survey said, five. Ketchup was number one. Something delivered to people's homes, you said. Newspaper, survey said, 30. The mail.
Well, you see, my mailbox got with mudslides, so I don't have the mail coming.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Sorry to hear that. Something you do with your mouth, we asked. You said, eat. It is the number one answer. But you need 68 points for the money. Survey said, 50. 182, $5 for every point. You got a total of $910. And you're in the final.
Great.
Angie will play Benson for $10,000. Right after we watch this.
The usual, Mrs. Taylor?
Yes, please.
The usual for Mrs. Taylor.
What do you think her story is?
Well, her husband died, but that was a couple of years ago.
That'd be tough.
Obviously.
Maybe what she needs are a couple of friends.
The teachings that can change the world haven't changed. These teachings are found in the Holy Bible. You can receive your free copy of the King James Version of the Bible just by calling this number.
May we join you?
Yes.
The Bible is filled with the teachings of Jesus Christ. Reading these teachings can inspire us to follow his example and make the world a better place. You can have a free copy of the King James Version of the Holy Bible when you call this number. It's a gift to you from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Call now for your free copy.
It's a beautiful morning.
This is my favorite time to skate. I guess it's from all those years of 5 a.m. practices. But it's also the time when the pain and stiffness of osteoarthritis can be at their worst.
Ask your doctor about ways to help relieve the pain of osteoarthritis. Call 1-888-MERC-55 for more information.
Now, last time we had the special CBS beat out our buddies here, but this time, the two ABC shows are triumphant. Benson, you're playing for sickle cell anemia. There are $10,000 at stake. The tree people for Angie right here. Let's go. This is the biggie. Okay. Wish each other luck. Now, this time, $10,000 is at stake, and this time, only one question is involved. This will decide who will play for $10,000. 100 people surveyed. Top seven answers are on the board. Try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something people keep near their bed.
Alarm clock.
An alarm clock. Number one answer. You're going to play or pass?
Play or pass?
Play.
We're going to play. I'm Missy.
Hi.
Can't talk.
Something that people keep near their bed.
The telephone.
Very good.
Yeah. All right, Chippy.
Missy said a telephone.
A television remote control.
Very good. Let's take a look. Not bad. First strike. And to my left. Something people keep near their bed.
The Bible.
The Bible. All right.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good
one. Let me see if any of our 100 people said the Bible. One second.
I think a bedside lamp.
A lamp?
Yeah. Sounds like a good answer.
The lamp is there. You're all right. If not, third strike, Angie's got a chance to steal. Lamp! You got it. Four answers left, Robert. Something people keep near their bed.
Pad and pencil.
Okay. That's there. Again, you're okay. If not, they get a chance to dethrone you. Pad and pencil! Not there. And Jesus can decide whether you'll play for $10,000 or not. What do you say?
I say book.
I do. Kleenex, Kleenex.
Book.
Yeah.
What? Radio.
We're going to say.
I need an answer, quick.
Book. Book. Do you want to go with book?
Sure. Anything.
No. Book. The Bible is
yeah.
A book.
Yeah.
How about radio?
All right. Okay, we'll go with radio.
Yeah. Okay. Radio's up there. You get the $82 and the right to play for $10,000. If it's not there, Benson's will do it. Radio! Number four. Flipper. Number five. Nightstand. Number six. Bathrobe. Number seven. Dishes. Yes, you first.
Are
going for $10,000. All righty.
$10,000.
Well, you did it before. You won. Just a piece of cake.
Okay.
Let me know. All is well over there? Eduardo? He cannot hear. This is for luck.
Yes, thank you.
$10,000. I just know you're going to do it. 15 seconds, please. Name something you'd hate to be wearing when unexpected company arrives.
Nothing.
A popular month for vacations.
June.
Something that hurts when you have a cold.
Your nose.
A color of shoe polish.
Black.
Any foreign language.
French.
Turn around. And something you'd hate to be wearing when unexpected company arrives. And you said, Zippo. Survey said. 50. Popular month for vacations, you said, June. Survey said 19. That's 34. Something that hurts when you have a cold, you said your nose. Survey said 27. That's 61. Color of shoe polish, you said black. Survey said 43. Any foreign language? You said France. Well, so I said.
You are good. Good job.
Here's Ross. Let's go, Ross. It's 154. You were 46 points away from $10,000. Was the sickle cell. Okay. Wants you to get the money. I'll ask you the same question I asked Inga. Can't duplicate her answers if you do. Hear that? Say, try again, give me another answer, okay?
Okay.
Please remind everyone the answers Inga gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. We wish you luck. Name something you'd hate to be wearing when unexpected company arrives.
Nothing.
Try again.
Underwear.
A popular month for vacations.
Summer.
Month.
December.
Something that hurts when you have a cold.
Your nose.
Try again.
Your tonsils.
A color. But people laughed. Did you have the buzzer then? He's got to hear. People were laughing and I couldn't read over the laugh. Color of shoe polish.
Black.
Try again.
Brown.
Any foreign language.
Spanish.
Turn around. Yeah. I thought so. You don't leave me there. Oh.
Thank you.
Okay, here we go. Something you'd hate to be wearing when unexpected company arrives. You said your undies. You're 46 points away from $10,000. Survey said 8. Night clothes, like pajamas or nightgown, number one answer. 38 points you need. Popular month for vacations. You said December. Well, people go on. I went on a vacation.
Christmas?
Yeah, Christmas. Don't get testy, but. Survey said 0. July was the number one answer. Then something that hurts when you have a cold, you said?
A loser.
Why? Where are they? That hurts when you have a cold.
I think so.
Unless you've had a mild. 38 points for $10,000. Survey said? 0. Oh. Your throat was number one. Then a color of shoe polish. You said?
Brown.
Brown. still need 38 points. Survey said. Black was the number one answer. And then any foreign language, we said. French was number one. You said Spanish. 6 points. $10,000. Survey said. Oh!
Beautiful morning.
Ask your doctor about Vioxx, a prescription medicine from Merck. And find out if Vioxx is right for you. Vioxx.
The new Silverado is here. Now with quadrasteer four-wheel steering, it's the most maneuverable full-size pickup you can get. Silverado, the truck from Chevy.
And that's their final timeout. 6:23.
Got a minute? Why not whiten your teeth with new Colgate Simply White? Just apply the clear gel twice a day. You'll have whiter teeth in 2 weeks.
Teams are back on the court.
New Colgate Simply White.
It's the winter. America's favorite way to squirt and mop is Clorox Ready Mop. Maybe because we squirt the right stuff. Clorox Floor Cleaner.
With the Clorox Cleaner, there's no question. You just know it gets your whole floor clean.
It works great on my hardwood floors, and I don't have to worry about batteries.
When you're done, just toss the pad, dirt, and all. What could be simpler? Clorox Ready Mop Mopping System. Real mopping made simple.
What's more common in women than green eyes or freckled faces? Thinning hair. More than 30 million women have it. That's why there's Rogaine, the first FDA-approved treatment clinically proven to regrow hair. There's hope. There's help. There's Rogaine.
On the way, more Family Feud Friday. Then it's Lingo, followed by the game where you find out who your real friends are. Friend or foe? You're watching Feud Friday, only on Game Show Network. Stay tuned.
I had a good time. Thank you. I want to thank all the celebrities for giving up their time and their day off to play for charity. I'd like to thank all my friends here from Dallas who played for the Kennedy Child Study Center. They have $1,000, and I thank you. My buddies WKRP in Cincinnati for St. John's Hospital. $1,000. And my sweethearts here from Angie. This time for the tree people, they have $1,150. And the champ, second time on our show, but of course this time they brought Pretty Missy, who certainly was a good player and I think a good luck charm. You have, for the Sickle Cell Disease Research Foundation, $15,326. Hand those out to everybody. Okay. All righty. There. Inga. This is for you. We love you, and we'll see you on the field. Bye-bye.
This is Gene.
Let's play Russian roulette.
That's not good.
See ya.
Drop in for all new episodes of Russian Roulette tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern only on Game Show Network.